Hey there, friend. It looks like Mia is just finishing up a number story for today's math mystery. Let's read it. Mia has 34 crayons in her box. Her friend Toby has 24 crayons. How many crayons do they have in all?
Whoa, those are some big numbers.
Which strategy should we use to solve this one? Think, think, think. We know we have many strategies to solve addition problems, but these numbers are bigger than any numbers we've added before. Drawing a picture will take forever. Counting snap cubes will take even longer, and we'd have to use a 100 chart to count up this high. I think we're gonna get to learn something new. We're definitely going to learn something new today. When we add smaller numbers, like 12 plus 5, we can draw a quick picture, use snap cubes, space 10 blocks, or even our number line to find the answer. But in today's math mystery, we're adding 34 plus 24. We're adding two-digit numbers together, which means we need a new strategy. Check this out. We've practiced adding single-digit numbers horizontally or side-by-side, like this. But when we add two-digit numbers, like 43 and 26, for example, we stack them vertically or on top of each other, like this. The cool thing about vertical addition is that it actually makes adding a lot simpler. Instead of adding two big numbers, we just add the ones together here and the tens together here. Let me show you how it works. The number 43 has 4 tens and 3 ones. The number 26 has 2 tens and 6 ones. If we were going to use base 10 blocks to add these two numbers together, what would we do first? We would start by adding the ones together. When we add numbers vertically, we start with the ones too. Starting at the top, we have 3 ones plus 6 ones. What is 3 plus 6? 9. But where do we write our answer? This line here is like the equal sign in vertical addition. We write our answer below the ones underneath the line. Perfect. Now, what do you think we do next? We need to add the tens, just like we do when we add using base 10 blocks. Starting at the top, we have 4 tens plus 2 tens. What is 4 plus 2? 6. So we write 6 below the tens here. And look at that! Now we have a two-digit number below our vertical addition problem. 43 plus 26 equals 69. When we add two-digit numbers vertically or from top to bottom, we follow the same steps we would if we were adding with base 10 blocks. First we add the ones, and then we add the tens. Now that we have some practice, I think we're ready to solve Mia's math mystery. Let's reread the number story. Mia has 34 crayons in her box. Her friend Toby has 24 crayons. How many crayons do they have in all? First things first, we need to write this addition problem vertically. Mia has 34 crayons, so we'll write that here. Her friend Toby has 24, so we'll write that number below. Wait a second, that doesn't look right. What do I need to change? Aha! I need to move this number over so that the tens and ones are lined up. There we go. Now we add a plus sign on the side, draw a line below to represent the equal sign, and we're ready to find the answer. What do we need to add first? We need to add the ones from top to bottom. 4 plus 4 equals 8. And where do we write the 8? Right below the 1s. Perfect. Now we add the 10s from top to bottom. 2 plus 3 equals 5. Once we write the 5 below the 10s, we can see our two-digit answer. What is it? 34 plus 24 equals 58. Great job! Wow, friend, we tackled a big challenge today. We learned how to add two-digit numbers with the help of a new strategy, vertical addition. Vertical addition helps us break bigger numbers into smaller parts so we can add the numbers together quickly. Remember, we have all the tools we need to solve any problem. See you next time! Hey, hey.